Hello, my name is Rico Bertes and I'm a researcher at the Amsterdam University of Applied Sciences. In this lecture, I'll discuss how managing a fleet of electric vehicles differs from managing your regular fleet. Both private business fleets as public transport and service fleets will be discussed. Vehicle fleets exist in many different areas, from regular businesses like company car fleets, car sharing fleets, taxis, transport, delivery and service vehicles, or vehicles in the public sector. For instance, police cars, city buses and garbage trucks. Each of the vehicles are used in different ways and the management of these fleets is therefore completely different per mobility application. Managing a fleet of vehicles compromises of many components. In this lecture, we will first discuss how the purchase decision is done and which additional considerations are needed for electric vehicles. Secondly, we will look at how driving differs with electric vehicles and which aspects play an important role. Thirdly, we look at how to design the charging infrastructure needed for EV fleets. Thereafter, we will look at which monitoring systems can be used. And lastly, we will discuss how fleet management in the public and private sector differ from each other. When building a new fleet or replacing an old one, a fleet manager can consider to switch to electric vehicles. A seasoned fleet manager knows that not only the purchase price of the vehicle matters, but also the cost of driving, maintenance, resale value and some other specific elements like capital cost, uptime and depreciation period add to the total cost of ownership. Comparing a fleet on its total cost of ownership, often calculated per year or per kilometer, gives the best comparison on the financial consequences of switching to electric cars. Although, if some cost elements are the same or irrelevant, it could be simplified to a differential cost of ownership. For instance, in many cases, the wage of a chauffeur is not calculated. And it helps to make the simplest rule of thumb calculation first. If per kilometer, the electricity cost plus depreciation cost of the battery is lower than the fuel costs, an EV is likely to be more cost efficient than a comparable combustion vehicle. Or in other words, the higher upfront investment cost of electric vehicles should be compensated by lower driving and maintenance costs in a reasonable break-even time. When looking for zero-emission alternatives for gasoline or diesel-driven cars, in many cases one finds that currently there are not many electric options available. This picture from Transport and Environment shows that only less than 20 full electric passenger car models were on the market in 2017. This could mean that a vehicle in your segment with the desired size and range is not yet available. However, the number of different models is growing very fast, meaning that more options will soon be available. Based on product planning information from OEMs, it is forecasted that by 2022, more than 100 different models from nearly all major automobile makers are available. Also, in all other automotive segments, this shift to EV will happen in due time. Before the acquisition process of a fleet, it is good to identify the needs of your drivers. Does your fleet need to be uniform or would different types of vehicles be better? One of the important things to consider when looking at electric vehicles is the range. Whether or not an electric car provides enough range depends on your driving patterns. When your cars drive more than 500 km a day, without barely stopping, electric vehicles might not be the best choice. However, when on average more than 90% of the daily mileage is below 100 km, which is below the average range of a full electric vehicle, an EV can be a good fit to your driving cycle. But possible exceptions in the driving patterns should also be considered. In these cases, a differentiation in the fleet with plug-in hybrid or fuel cell electric can still offer an EV solution. Also important to consider is whether there is enough recharging infrastructure on your premises, in your neighborhood or in your country. In many places, there can still be a limiting factor in switching to electric vehicles. When building a new fleet, one frequently chooses the option to lease the vehicle instead of purchasing them. This has the advantage that many of the uncertainties regarding, for example, battery life and maintenance, insurance and depreciation costs are covered. Also, one does not have to manage the reselling of the vehicles. For electric vehicles, the resale value is an uncertain factor due to the fast technical developments and financial incentives in the markets. Leasing requires payments on a monthly basis, and therefore no high investments have to be booked. When considering purchasing the vehicles, a tender process could be most suitable. In this process, multiple contractors are asked to come with an offer from which the best one, based on your company's criteria, can be chosen. Once purchased, a fleet manager will try to keep the driving cost to a minimum. Energy efficiency in electric vehicles is even more important due to the limited range, but also because of the differences in behavior of the driveline between the electric motor compared to the gasoline engine. By laws of physics, the force needed to move an electric vehicle increases in a quadratic manner to the speed, as is shown in this formula. This only partially holds for gasoline engines. Due to the gear system and poor idling and low speed energy efficiency, we became used to the effect that internal combustion vehicles have a high consumption at city cycles and that the consumption gets better at more constant higher speeds. Electric vehicles show constant high energy efficiency independent from speed. Therefore, they are very suited for city driving with low speeds, but following the laws of physics, at zero speed they use no energy, but at increasing speed the energy consumption increases, and as a consequence the range decreases. This better urban efficiency of EVs is reinforced at fluctuating or stop and go traffic. Thanks to the characteristics of the electric motors, EVs come with regenerative braking. Regenerative braking captures the energy lost during deceleration and normal braking. In the urban environment, the regeneration can be up to 35% of the energy to propel the vehicle. This regeneration works also positive in hilly areas. What needed to go up is recuperated while going down. Only hard braking reduces the fuel economy and limits the range. But due to the lack of waste heat and the need to warm the batteries, there is a substantial difference in the range that can be reached in winter and in summer. Especially in cold temperatures and when the electric heating in the car is on, the range and efficiency of the vehicles can drop significantly. These changes require a different driving style and climate control strategy from your drivers, and they may need to get used to it. Fortunately, in modern EVs, pre-trip heating and heat pump technology limits its effect to a minimum. It is a known fact that on average cars are parked for 95% of the time. The asset utilization rate is therefore very low. In a shared pool system, this can be optimized. This can also be a good way to shift to electric vehicles without creating range anxiety among your drivers. Always a fresh horse available. Keeping a few plug-in hybrid, fuel cell electric or even gasoline-driven vehicles in the pool for longer trips could serve all your driving needs. Going even further is the concept of mobility as a service, in which your drivers can choose the most suitable modes of transport, which can include public transport and bikes on demand. Recharging the electric car happens in a completely different way compared to refueling gasoline-driven cars. When switching to electric cars, you need to have enough chargers at the office or at your depot. But what is enough? This question depends on the number of vehicles and the number of parking spaces. Under or over-utilization of charging points can be a source of complaints. Energy management should also be considered. The grid connection of your building might not have enough capacity to charge a large fleet at once, or upgrading this connection can be costly. Looking for solutions such as smart charging, in which the vehicle is only charged when enough renewable power is available, can significantly reduce costs. Of course, smart charging should not be in conflict with the availability of vehicles. For accessing charging points on the road, most charging point operators require a charging card or an app. Such charging cards are provided by so-called mobility service providers. These have a similar role as fuel card providers. It should be noted that in many countries, not all charging cards are interoperable with all charging points. Especially when going abroad, planning is needed. Refueling costs are an important aspect of fleet management. Costs of charging can vary significantly from completely free to prices that are more expensive than driving on gasoline. A good overview of the cost of different chargers can save a lot of money. Experience from the Netherlands shows that charging plug-in hybrids can be problematic. Plug-in hybrids are only more economically efficient than gasoline engines if charged enough. Research shows that 50% of all daily trips can be made if the vehicle is only charged overnight. It is therefore important to motivate the drivers to charge by, for example, offering home charging through gamification or making it obligatory by an energy budget. It is better to use slow parking place chargers to completely fill your battery and only use fast chargers to fill up to 80% full when needed on the route. The last 20% recharge will take much more energy and time. This is due to the battery characteristics and the thermal battery management system in place to avoid significant battery degradation when fast charging. Often fast charging, when not needed, is risking unnecessary reduced lifetime of the vehicle. In general, the cost of maintenance for electric vehicles is much lower than for fossil fuel driven cars, because of the lower number of wearing components involved. Some studies even show more than 75% reduction in maintenance costs. There are three options for maintenance of your fleets. First, doing it in-house, outsource the maintenance, or have a contract contracted as part of the leasing contract. When considering electric vehicles, it is good to note that the number of garages or specialized engineers is limited and special training is needed. In the early market, you're most likely stuck to the dealership for maintenance. Retrofitted vehicles are in some developing market segments still the only choice. But be aware that the very limited service network, the custom retrofit bills can be a problem for long-term maintenance and fast help with technical problems. Fleet monitoring is often a process that is quite cumbersome. Drivers have to keep logs of when and how far their car has been driven and for which purpose. From this, the fleet manager makes calculations on the fuel economy, expected maintenance and replacement needs. Most modern electric vehicles are connected and offer already some monitoring functions, as also many other new vehicles are becoming more often connected. The performance of the fleet is available instantly through an app, making the life of an e-fleet manager and also the driver much easier. This talk has been mainly about fleets from a business perspective, yet fleets are also important for public stakeholders, buses being the most prominent example. If such a fleet is to be switched to a fully electric, it is important to consider that longer timescales are needed to recoup the additional investments. Tenders can be adjusted in that respect to favor electric vehicles. Also, policymakers should consider investing into developing the relevant charging infrastructure, as such costs are nearly zero for conventional driven vehicles. A realistic and cooperative roadmap that safeguards the high quality public service is needed to build successful public EV fleets and to set a good example for society. Thank you for watching the video on the management of EV fleets.